Just up there.
I hear you dig, dig, start walking over there.
It would have been easier just to go through the
floor. Well, why you gotta yell at?
Thank you. evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Foster Field as the 2012 All-Star Conference Baseball Championship Tournament continues. This championship game features the Tarleton State Texans and the Angelo State Rams. Here's the starting lineup of the visiting Tarleton State Texans, winning off the second base of junior from Longview, number 8, Ryan Small. Back second is center fielder senior from Dripping Springs, number 2, Andrew Wolf. Batting third in the inch, senior from Cedar Park, number 7, Blake Sapiro. Batting cleanup, the first base is senior from Arlington, number 23, Garrett.
Tradition's essential to the lifeblood of any institution, any athletic department. When you consider tradition, that's really the one thing that speaks excellence. It speaks things that are very important to the people who have come through and laid groundwork for your programs in the past. And it's really the one element that really ties people together and ties just the element of success and excellence to those that are in the program now.
Commitment to me is exercising discipline in your endeavors, whether it's academically, athletically, in my position and role as an assistant athletic director or whatever. And the discipline side of it is, in my mind, is doing what needs to be done the way it needs to be done every time.
Integrity in athletics should be a reflection of the value that we place on integrity within the entire institution. Integrity is really the bedrock. It's the foundation upon which everything else we do is built. The thing that I stress to our students especially is not only the reality of integrity, but the perception of integrity. Yeah, it's important to do the right thing. It's important to do the right thing for the right reason. But it's also important for other people to know that you're doing the right thing.
Academic excellence is every student athlete having success in the classroom so that they have an opportunity to get a marketable degree to advance in life as they leave the university.
You know, when you talk about a bridge building between the community and Tarleton, I think that we have more than a bridge, I think we have a four-lane highway right now, because we have so much interaction between our community. They have a ownership in Tarleton State University. They feel like they are so welcomed here. They feel like they are a part of this university. And when you can build that special relationship between university and community, I think you have something that is a win-win situation. I think it's something that you can really build on.
I think respect is very, very important in your team, and within your team you have to respect each other as players and respect your coaching staff. And we talk about a lot that respect comes down to the golden rule: treat others the way you want to be treated, look each other in the eye when they're talking, body language, always have positive body language. So respect is essential in order to have a good team and a good program.
My name is Stan Wyden, Commissioner of the Lone Star Conference. Our mission in the Lone Star Conference is to foster student participation and success among member institutions in Division II athletic.
Hello and welcome to the Lone Star Conference Baseball Tournament Championship Game tonight. Graham Doty here at Foster Field, and the championship game features the Tarleton State Texans taking on the Angelo State Rams. And you see the Rams right there, they're the number one seed. And this is the championship game, which you see on the right. On the left is how we got here. Abilene Christian eliminated Incarnate Word earlier today in game number 8. The ninth game, Tarleton State knocked out Abilene Christian just about 30 minutes ago. And here we are at the championship game. Angelo State, the home team, taking on Tarleton State. And if necessary, if Tarleton State knocks off the Rams, we will play one more tomorrow. Starting lineups, first for Tarleton State, Ryan Small, the second baseman, leading things off. Andrew Wolf behind him, the center fielder. Batting third, the DH is Blake Salguero. In the cleanup spot, Garrett Hardy, the first baseman. Jonathan Schmitz, the catcher, batting fifth. Landon Thompson at the third baseman, batting sixth. The left fielder, Chris Patton, in the seventh spot. Batting eighth is Ty Crump in right field. Batting last is Evan Robinson, the shortstop. Now the starting lineup for the Rams. Zach Cohen, the shortstop, leading things off. Quade McKinnon at first base. Toby Simler batting third, also playing third base. Batting fourth is Brett Parsons, the DH. In the five spot in center field is Lee Newman. The left fielder, Ryan Greer, is batting sixth. Hitting seventh is Doug Snover, the second baseman. The catcher, Andrew Lacombe, hits eighth. And Tate Allison rounds things out, batting last for Angelo State. He is in right field. And we are ready for first pitch here in the title game between Angelo State and Tarleton State. These two teams have played each other 5 times this season, with the Rams winning 3 of those, including one time here in the tournament. Yesterday, Angelo State won 16-0 over Tarleton State just a day ago. Starting pitchers, first for Angelo State, Rick Reyna gets the nod here in the championship game. Ryan Small leading things off, the first pitch from Reyna. Drops in, strike one. Numbers this year for Reyna, 5 wins, 4 losses. Tonight makes his 13th start, a 3.54 ERA. His 0-1 pitch is bunted foul. It's 1-1 to Small. Reyna has thrown 61 innings, allowed 65 hits, 32 runs. 24 of those runs are earned. 57 strikeouts, tops on the team, and only 27 walks this season for Rick Reyna. His 0-2 pitch to Small. Fouled off, stays 0-2. Small this year for Tarleton State comes in this game batting .320, 9 home runs and 45 RBIs. Tarleton State led by head coach Brian Conger, fourth year as the head coach for the Texans. That ball is shot foul, stays 0-2. Head coach for the Angelo State Rams, Kevin Brooks, 8 years as the head coach here at Angelo State. The Rams last year 25-23. This year picked preseason number 4 coming in for the regular season. 1-2 now to Ryan Small. The Rams, this marks their 4th championship appearance. They have won the whole tournament once before, back in 2007 when they eventually went on to the World Series. 1-2 pitch, swing on and miss, strike 3. Rick Reyna strikes out the first batter that he sees. 1 down.
Center fielder Andrew Wolf.
Andrew Wolf, the batter. Tarleton State. Texans went 35-15 last year, a school record. They lost 16 seniors from that team. Showing bunt, strike 1 to Wolf. Texans were picked preseason 2nd. 5th time to reach the championship game. They have won this tournament twice. 0-1 pitch, fouled off for strike 2. Andrew Wolf came in the tournament batting .323 with 33 RBIs. He made the honorable mention team this year in the Lone Star Conference. 0-2 pitch in the dirt, 1-2. Wolf, the player of the week, March 19th, 11-15 with 10 RBIs versus Eastern New Mexico. Has started every game this year for the Texans. 2 pitch downstairs. The count's level, 2-2. Against Abilene Christian just a few hours ago, Wolf went 1-for-2 with an RBI. Marina's 2-2 pitch, just a little bit inside, full count. Rick Marina making his first appearance in this tournament. His payoff pitch, loop shot right side, Andrew Wolf was the first base hit tonight. Brings up the DH, Blake Seguero. Seguero's second on the team with a 3.42 average. Leads the Lone Star Conference in home runs with 11, 38 RBIs. Just underway here, Graham Doty at Foster Field for the championship game. 1-1 to Seguero. Rick Reno, the pitcher of the week, twice this year, March the 1st and February 7th, is 1-0 delivery. Slow rolling, this could be two. Cohen underhands it to Snover for one. The in time for the Super Bowl. Double play. The top of the first is over. We are scoreless. Rams go to the
The LSC would like to thank the following corporate partners. Firestone, we keep your car running newer, longer. Three shops, one stop, maintenance, repairs, and tires. AccuConference, providing conference calling for the Lone Star Conference. Shut Sports, official softball helmet of the Lone Star Conference. Alpha Graphics, providing printing solutions for the Lone Star Conference. My Sports Streams, providing fundraising solutions for Lone Star Conference member institutions. Bravo Health, community engagement partner of the Lone Star Conference. Adidas, official supplier of the Lone Star Conference. Jostens, official ring provider of the Lone Star Conference. Wilson, the official basketball of the LSC. In the Lone Star Conference, we're committed to respect, integrity, tradition, community, and academic excellence. Lone Star Conference, we're the one. Fans, don't forget to like the Lone Star Conference on Facebook. It's the best way to stay connected to all the latest information from around the league and join the conversation with other LSC fans. For an easy way to follow the latest happenings in the Lone Star Conference, be sure to follow the LSC on Twitter. Get scoring updates, event reminders, and breaking news when you follow the Lone Star Conference on Twitter.
Graham Doty here, Foster Field, four scores. Pete Perez starting tonight for the Texans. Pete Perez, phenomenal this year for Tarleton State. 9-3, a 2.29 ERA, making his 14th start. He has thrown 85 innings, allowed 62 hits, 30 runs, 77 strikeouts and only 18 walks this year for Perez. Zach Cohen will lead things off here for Angelo State. Take you through the defense real quick for the Texans from left field to right. Chris Patton in left, Andrew Wood playing center field, Ty Cobb in right. From third to first, Landon Thompson, Evan Robinson short, Ryan Small playing second. First baseman is Garrett Hardy. Behind the plate catching, Jonathan Schmitz and Pete Perez on the mound. Zach Cohen, the shortstop, steps in. Batting 229, one homer, 22 RBIs, takes a first pitch strike. 0-1 pitch. He fouls it off. 0-2. Cohen, the Academic Player of the Year in the Lone Star Conference, also made the honorable mention team. He is the team captain this year for the Rams. Two pitch from Perez, high and away, ball one. Cohen missed the first few games of the season this year because he hurt his ankle in practice, sliding into second base. Close to first base. Leadoff runner is aboard for Quade McKinnon. Cohen leads Angelo State in career hit by pitches. He's aboard on first right now. Quade McKinnon steps in. McKinnon this year, 356 average, 3 home runs and 46 RBIs. Takes one low, ball one. McKinnon, first team all-conference. He's been the player of the week twice this year. Throw over, Cohen gets back to the bag safely. Cohen has 7 stolen bases this year, has only been caught once. But McKinnon played 2 years at Paradise Valley Community College. Another good eye, they appealed a third. He did not go around. 2-0. McKinnon, a junior from Phoenix, Arizona. This 2-0 pitch takes a strike. Now it's 2-1. Just underway here in the bottom of the first. We are scoreless for the championship game. Tarleton State would have to defeat the Rams twice if they want to win the championship. Go over. Going again, gets back in safely. The Rams are 25-9 all time against Tarleton State. 3-0 against the Texans in the tournament, including a 16-0 victory earlier in the tournament. 2-1 pitch is popped up out of play. Thompson gives it a look. 2 balls, 2 strikes to McKinnon. Pete Perez, a first team conference pick this year. There you see him pitching from the stretch. His 2-2 pitch, strike 3 call. He gets McKinnon looking for the first out. Up Toby Simler, the third baseman, batting 366, 3 home runs and 39 runs batted in. Perez, the pitcher of the week on February 7th, throws a dart over to first, but Cohen gets back in safely. When he was named the pitcher of the week, he threw 6 innings. 6 strikeouts, no walks, only allowed 1 hit. Throw over, Cohen again gets back to the bag safely. Perez has been the pitcher of the week a bunch of times. March the 6th, 8 shutout innings against Cameron. He had 10 strikeouts, 4 hits, and 2 walks allowed. On March 26th against West Texas A&M, 7 shutout innings, only allowed 2 hits and 2 walks. Runner goes first base. This is a foul ball. So it's 0-1 to Simler. 1 out, 1 on. I'm playing umpire has to get up and say, that's a foul ball. As Cohen has to trot back towards first base. Perez is second in the conference in strikeouts. Played 2 years at American River Community College, where he led the team in strikeouts. 0-1 pitch in the dirt, gets past Schmidt. Kilwin goes to second base, standing up. Runner in scoring position for the Rams here. One out in the bottom of the first. Similar, the senior from Mansfield, Texas. Mansfield Summit High School. The 1-1 pitch hits it in the air towards center field. Andrew Wolf settles underneath it, makes the catch. Two down. Here comes Brett Parsons, the DH. An RBI opportunity for Parsons, batting 367. Four home runs and 42 RBIs. Fourth most on the team. Parsons, a senior from Trinity, Texas, the Woodlands High School. Slaps that one foul for strike one. Parsons, first team all conference selection. Eight Angelo State players. First team conference picks this year. Parsons played 2 years at Texas A&M, played in 56 games for the Aggies. The 0-1 pitch, how is that one off? He's down in the count, nothing and two. Parsons drafted out of high school by the Tampa Bay Raves on the 2006 Texas 5A State Championship at the Woodlands High School. His team went 38-1. Also the quarterback on the football team. Swings and misses there. Throw down to first from Schmitz is in time. The inning is over. Two strikeouts for Pete Perez. We are scoreless as we go to the top of the second. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. Welcome back, Graham Doty here at Foster Field, scoreless as we make our way to the top of the second. Garrett Hardy leads the inning off here for Tarleton State. Last game for Hardy, 1-for-3, also with a walk. He cleaned up as well against Abilene Christian. Strolls up to the plate here. In a championship game here in the Lone Star Conference. If you win the tournament, you automatically qualify postseason play to advance to the regionals. First pitch from Reyna, upstairs, ball one. Hardy this year comes in batting 323. Seven home runs and 38 RBIs. The 1-0 from Reyna nips the outside corner. Level, 1-1. One-one pitch from Reyna is fouled off. Strike two. Reyna, earlier this year, threw six scoreless innings with 12 strikeouts with tied the school record. Only gave up three hits. His 1-2 pitch here, a bouncer to the third baseman, similar, throws a dart over to first, and the first out.
catcher, Jonathan Schmitz.
Brings up Jonathan Schmitz. Just a freshman from College Station. One of three freshmen that have played a good deal here for the Texans this season. Kind of due to some injuries. Evan Robinson, another one of those freshmen that has stepped up. Landon Thompson as well. 1-0 to Schmitz. At Reyna last year, 14 games he started, went 5-4 in 64 innings. He played 2 years at Southeastern Community College in Iowa. Also played football and golf in high school. There you see him on the mound right now. Kicks and deals the 1-1. Drops a little low, 2-1 to Schmitz. Schmitz's mom played basketball at Texas Tech as he shoots that one in shallow center field. Newman on the run, makes the catch, his hat pops off. 2-0. Brings up the third baseman, Landon Thompson. Just mentioned one of the freshmen that have had a good year this year for the Texans. Rolls that one a third. It's fair. Simler throws a bullet over. It's a 1-2-3. Top half of the second. Scoreless, we go to the bottom of the second between Angelo State and Tarleton State here in the Lone Star Conference championship game. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
I chose Division II because athletes graduate at a higher rate.
I can stay closer to home and be an important part of the community. I chose Division II because I can double major
and take part in campus activities.
I chose Division II because classrooms are smaller.
Students have more time with their instructors.
And I can compete for a national championship.
I chose Division II for all these reasons and more.
I chose
Division II.
What is Javelina Pride? It's learning by doing research. It's tailgating before the big game. It's being part of a world-respected engineering program. Texas A&M University, Kingsville, the home of Javelina Pride. Find out more at tamuk.edu.
There you see it, the Lone Star Conference Baseball Championship. Graham Doty here at Foster Field. We are scoreless. Rams dugout cheering on Lee Newman, leading things off here for Angelo State. Newman, the co-conference player of the year, batting .408 to lead Angelo State. 7 home runs, 45 RBIs. Takes one in the dirt for ball one. He's got a hole in the left side of his pants. 1-0 pitch, 1-0 and missed. 1-1. First time today that Angelo State has played, but they have played a couple of games so far. There you see it. That's a pretty big gash there in those pants. 1-2 to Lee Newman. Newman, a junior from Brigham, Texas, Brenham High School. A 1-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. Strike three. Back-to-back strikeouts for Pete Perez. His third tonight. Brings up Ryan Greer. Greer second on the team with a 367 average. six homers, 56 RBIs. Shoots that one to the first baseman, Hardy, bobbles it, and finishes it off. Taps the bag, two away. Brings up Doug Snover. Scoreless here in the bottom of the second. Snover, a senior from Tempe, Arizona. First pitch shows bunt, chops one foul. Snover, academic Lone Star pick this year. Second in the conference in stolen bases. Said he's from Tempe. He originally attended Arizona State. Tried to walk on the baseball team for the Sun Devils. In the dirt, 1-1. Didn't play last year. He broke his collarbone 2 days before the season started. The 1-1 from Perez. Runs outside. It's 2-1. Snover played 2 years at Gateway Community College. Second team All-American out there. Curveball floats in, even 2-2. Angelo State got here by winning on Saturday 11-1 over Abilene Christian. And yesterday over Tarleton State. 2-2 pitch, a slow roller right side. First baseman Hardy bobbles it, can't make the play, and Snover is aboard with two outs. That is an error on the first baseman, Garrett Hardy. Eleventh error this year for Hardy. That brings up the catcher, Andrew Lacombe. Lacombe, a junior from Southlake, Texas, a throw over. Snover gets back safely. Lacombe, Southlake Carroll High School. Spent 2 years at Texas State, where he played in 30 games. There's a strike on the outer corner. His team finishes the Texas 5A state tournament runner-up at Southlake Carroll High School. Lacombe, first team pick this year in the Lone Star Conference. But Snover on first. Close play once again, but he lunges back to the bag safely. 20 stolen bases this year for Snover. Second on the team. This Ram squad, second most stolen bases in the conference. He breaks here, the throw down a second base is in time. Snover is gunned down by Jonathan Schmitz to win the bottom of the second. We play two full innings. We are scoreless as we head to the top of the third. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
Angelo State University, affordable, better, closer. With one of the lowest tuition and fee schedules in Texas, Angelo State is affordable for all. Recognized by the Princeton Review as one of the top four public universities in the state, ASU is better than you imagine. And Angelo State's central location in Texas makes it closer than you think. Enjoy the freedom to explore your interests, cultivate your talents, and shape your future at Angelo State University. From here, it's possible.
What makes WT Athletics unique?
I do.
I do.
I do.
I do.
And so do you.
Yes, we have great facilities and championship programs, but it's the people that set us apart.
It's me and it's you.
Without our athletes and without our donors, we are just an organization. An organization without a cause.
Without a voice.
And without purpose. Thank you for supporting the Buffalo Club.
For more information, please visit GoBusGo.com.
Go Buffs!
Wind blowing in from center field. Rams go to here at Foster Field, scoreless, and the championship game between Tarleton State and Angelo State. Ryan Reno faces the bottom third of this Texans lineup.
Left fielder Chris Patton.
Chris Patton, the left fielder, steps in. First pitch to Patton, shows bunt, slaps it foul. Patton, a sophomore from San Antonio, hits the 0-1 pitch, a line drive right at the shortstop, Cohen. One down.
Brings up Ty Crump.
Crump is a junior from McKinney, Texas. Tarleton State, one hit so far, a single in the first. Right now, Rick Reyna has retired five straight. This could be six. Allison ranging over to his left, makes the catch. Now two away.
Shortstop, Evan Robinson.
Evan Robinson, the shortstop, will face Reyna for the first time tonight. Robinson, the freshman from Flower Mound, Texas. Comes in the tournament batting 281. 21 RBIs, takes one outside for there. Robinson 1-for-2 with a walk against the Wildcats earlier today. That pitch runs inside, it's 2-0. Pitch pops the mitt, but it's outside. 3-0 to Robinson. Tarleton State has to defeat the Rams twice. They want to win the championship. The 3-0 pitch, a 4-pitch walk. Reyna puts Robinson on top of the order coming up here for the Texans. First walk allowed tonight for Rick Reyna. Snaps the 6-in-a-row retired streak. Ryan Small struck out in the first. Steps back in. He's pretty much in the top three or five in almost every offensive category in the Lone Star Conference. Looks at ball one. Small played 2 years at Midland Community College. It was a first-team all-conference there. Hit over 400, over 20 RBIs.
All right, I'm Hayter. Mark
Hash. I'll be ready for end run out here. Be smart.
I'm Mark Hash.
Runner goes, pitches upstairs, throw down to second, is not in time. Second baseman Stover just missed the ball. So Robinson is in scoring position, two outs here for Ryan Small. He's been Mr. Clutch in this tournament for the Texans against Incarnate Word on Sunday. The base is loaded and two outs. Cardinals leading the Texans at that point 2-0, hit a bases clearing double, and the Texans went on to win 3-2. Takes a strike there. And the last game against the Wildcats, Small hit a go-ahead sack fly to put the Texans in front of the Wildcats 3-2. 2-1 pitch. Line drive, base hit right back up the middle. Robinson rounds third. Here comes the throw from Newman to home. It bounces, and the throw is in time. He's out. What a gun in center field by Lee Newman. We're still scoreless as we move to the bottom of the third. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
We strive for academic excellence. We believe in engaging our community. We're proud of our tradition. We exemplify respect on and off the field. We conduct ourselves with integrity, and we're committed to being the best. That's why we're the one. Lone Star Conference, we're the one.
8-9-1. At the plate here for Angelo State. Graham Doty here at Foster Field. We are scoreless in the championship game here in the Lone Star Conference baseball tournament.
This is the catcher, Andrew Lacombe.
It's the catcher, Andrew Lacombe, leading off here for the Rams. Lacombe batting 340, three home runs and 36 RBIs. Angelo State team, almost everybody batting over 300. The 1-0 runs inside for ball two. They have a team batting average of 321, which is the second best. Second most runs, hits, doubles, most triples. 2-0 pitch, there's a strike. 2-1 to Lacombe. Rams also have second best team ERA, second most strikeouts. 2-1 pitch, big swing and a miss, and the count's even, 2-2. Also best in the field, best fielding percentage, fewest errors, fewest stolen bases against. Big reason why they're the number one seed in hosting. 2-0 pitch, slow roller back to the mound. Perez takes his time, one away. Tate Allison, the right fielder, steps in. Allison batting 231, four homers, 22 RBIs. First pitch he sees, takes a strike.
There you go, Tate.
One pitch from Perez. Strike two. Talked about this throughout this tournament, but just such an unusual journey for Tate Allison. His family moving to Egypt when he was 11 years old. 0-2 pitch from Perez. He gets Allison on three pitches. Four strikeouts already for Perez. Top of the order here for the Rams. Pitch to Cohen. He looks at a strike. He reached back in the first, was left stranded at second. Scoreless here in the bottom of the third. Perez fires the 0-1. Now he's in front of Zach Cohen, nothing and two. These two teams played at Tarleton State during the regular season, April 13th through the 15th. They split the four-game series. But then they met here in the tournament, and Angelo State just creamed Tarleton State. Two and two. Rams 25-9 all time against the Texans. Have never lost to the Tarleton State in the tournament. There's a line drive, bloop shot right into the glove of Hardy at first. A spinning catch at first for Hardy. And the Rams go down 1-2-3 in the third. As we move to the top of the fourth, we are scoreless. This is the Lone Star Conference.
Angelo State University, affordable, better, closer. With one of the lowest tuition and fee schedules in Texas, Angelo State is affordable for all. Recognized by the Princeton Review as one of the top four public universities in the state, ASU is better than you imagine. And Angelo State's central location in Texas makes it closer than you think. Enjoy the freedom to explore your interests, cultivate your talents, and shape your future at Angelo State University. From here, it's possible.
Welcome back. Graham Doty here at Foster Field in the top of the fourth. Scoreless. These is some shots of just exactly how much rain we've had to deal with the past 2 days. This is the dugout. There's dead center field here at Foster Field. And we had a total of an 8-hour rain delay yesterday between these two teams. Angelo State's football team had to come out, put the tarp on the field, and take it off. You can see him right there attempting to take it off. It was just really windy. Luckily, it hasn't rained here today. Andrew Wolf leading things off here for the Texans. He's one for one with a single. Curveball drifts away from ball one. One oh pitch from Reno. It's the outside edge. One and one. Wolf, a senior from Dripping Springs, Texas. One of five brothers. That was a brother that played baseball at Western Texas College. Rolls that one to the second baseman, Snover. What a way. Brings up Blake Seguero. He's 0 for 1. Bounced into a double play to end the first. Ryan Conger trying to lead the Texans to another tournament title. Texans got right at the height at the right time. They finished the regular season winning 7 straight games. Tarleton State won their first game here in the tournament on Saturday, 4-2 over Texas A&M Kingsville. So the Texans certainly starting to peak at the right time here in postseason play. Shows bunt. Bunt's one in the air, foul, third base side for strike two. Coach Conger is from Stephenville, Texas, and played at Tarleton State. Was the pitching coach from 98 to 99. Now he's back as the head coach. 1-2 pitch from Reyna, just a little low. It's 2-2. Coach Conger said he wanted to come back. Be close to his family and friends. Said it's been a great move back to Stephenville. That ball is crushed deep towards left field. Ryan Greer goes back. He's at the warning track, and he makes the catch at the wall. Blake Seguero hit it hard, but not far enough. Two down. Two outs, base is empty for Garrett Hardy. He swings. This ball might be playable first base side. McKinnick gives it a chase, and it just bounces to about the third row here at Foster Field. 0-1 to Hardy. He grounded out to third base back in the second. Coach Conger certainly done a fantastic job as the head coach for the Texans. School record in wins last year. 2 years ago, Tarleton State finished above 500 for the first time in 7 years. Count is level to Hardy. One, one pitch, strike two. Hardy from Arlington, Texas. 1-2 pitch. Good eye, was able to lay off. It's 2-2. Out off, stays 2-2. Hardy spent 2 years at Western Texas Community College. He was the player of the week in the Lone Star Conference not that long ago, April 30th. 2-2 pitch, a slow roller, right side. Snover gloves, got to get it out quickly. He does. Three up and three down. On the Texans at the top of the fourth. Still scoreless as we move to the bottom of the fourth. Rams at the plate when we come back. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
Launch yourself into the future of technology at Eastern New Mexico University in Portales. When you experience the Eastern Way, you'll experience a state-of-the-art computer center, full access to the internet in classrooms and residence halls, college credit instructional TV courses in different cities and high schools, even student-produced programs on Eastern's own public radio and TV stations. For registration information or how to get launched aboard one of Eastern's 60 undergraduate and graduate majors, call 1-800-4-ENMU.
Wade McKinnon leads things off here in the bottom of the fourth. Graham Doty here at Foster Field for the Lone Star Conference Baseball Championship. McKinnon 0-1 with a strikeout. Takes strike one. One from Perez popped up out of play. 0-2 to McKinnon. Angelo State, the number one seed in this tournament. They're the highest ranked team in the Lone Star Conference in the South Central region. The 0-2 pitch, good eye from McKinnon. This is a little low, it's 1-2. Right now the Rams are the three seed. The top eight teams advance to the regionals. 1-2 pitch is tapped right back to Perez on the mound. Underhands it, one away.
Third baseman
to be similar. 5-4-0!
Right now, the Rams need help. Central Missouri St. Mary's are currently the 1 and 2 seeds in the South Central region. Those two teams will play their conference tournaments on Thursday. Central Missouri playing in Kansas City in the MIAA tournament as the first pitch hit high in the air, right side, foul territory. First baseman Garrett Hardy gives it a look. Strike one, though, to Simlin. And St. Mary's, the number one seed in the Heartland Conference baseball tournament. That is this Thursday, May 10th through Saturday. St. Mary's hosting that tournament at Incarnate Word at Sullivan Field. St. Mary's have a construction done on their field. Ball is hit in the air to a shallow right. Crump makes the catch. Two down here in the bottom of the fourth. Brings up Brett Parsons, 0-for-1 with a strikeout. But the Rams certainly would like to be the number one seed in the South Central Tournament so they can host it here at Foster Field. This is the first time the Lone Star Conference Tournament has been held here at Foster Field. That pitch runs away, and ball one. Angelo State sitting pretty right now at the 3 seed. They can certainly move up. One 0 pitch swung on and missed. The count is level 1-1. And if you think about it, Angelo State really hasn't been playing baseball all that long. Since 2005. That's nothing. 1-1 pitch popped up out of play, third base side. 1 ball, 2 strikes. They're the most recent athletic team added here at Angelo State. They have done very well. Have gone to the World Series in 2007. 1-2 pitch downstairs. It's 2-2 to Parsons. Parsons' first team conference selection this year. 13th best batting average in the Lone Star. Has worked it to a full count. The first full count tonight for Pete Perez. 2 outs, base is empty. In the bottom of the fourth. Swung on and missed, strike 3. Strikeout number 5 tonight for Pete Perez. He has retired 6 in a row. We are scoreless as we go to the top of the fifth. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
We strive for academic excellence. We believe in engaging our community. We're proud of our tradition. We exemplify respect on and off the field. We conduct ourselves with integrity, and we're committed to being the best. That's why we're the one. Lone Star Conference, we're the one.
There you see some Angelo State fans here at Foster Field. Top of the fifth, we are scoring. Great championship game so far here in the Lone Star Conference baseball tournament. The catcher, Jonathan Schmitz, 0-for-1, takes one in the dirt. Flew out to center field back in the second.
pitch from Reno. Moving away. Ball two. Angelo State, one of the hottest teams in the country. Pitch just a little off the plate, 3-0 to Schmitz. Rams have won 10 games in a row, 11 of the last 12. Pitch drops in for strike one. Last time Angelo State lost was against Cameron right here at Foster Field. Cameron won 3-1. 3-1 pitch, roll to the left side. Third baseman Simler throws it over. Gets Schmitz. One down. Each pitcher pitching very well. Four in a row retired by Rick Reno. Thompson 0-1 with a ground out. Bounces that one foul, first base side for strike one. Thompson won the 2011 Texas League All-Star Weekend Home Run Derby. Home run wise this year, four home runs for the Texans. Third most on the team. Throws that one off of strike two. This Texan squad, they do hit a lot of home runs. They're first in the Lone Star Conference. Two pitch, swung on and missed, strike three. Second strikeout tonight for Rick Reno. Five in a row retired. Brings up Chris Patton, 0-1 on the lineout. Pops that one up for strike one. The only hit in this game, rather both hits in this game for the Texans, single. A single by Andrew Wolf in the first and a single by Ryan Small in the third. 0-1 pitch in the dirt. It's 1-1. But three batters in the first for Rick Reno. 1-2-3 inning in the second. Four batters stepped up to the plate in the third. We had a play at the plate to win the third when Lee Newman gunned down Evan Robinson. 1-2-3 fourth inning. One ball, two strikes to Chris Patton. Rick Reno looking for his third strikeout tonight. Popped up, out of play. Stays 1-2. Marina's 1-2 is ripped foul. First base side. Let's do it one more time. One ball, two strikes to Chris Pat. Pitch number six on the way here for Rick Reno. Just barely got a piece of it. 1-2 it stays. Who will win this battle? Reina fires the 1-2, lifted in the air towards right field. Allison is there, makes the catch, and another 1-2-3 inning for Rick Reina. We are scoreless as we go to the bottom of
of the fifth. This is Lone Star.
After visiting Incarnate Word, I decided that the coaching staff, the professors, and the atmosphere were all a great fit for me.
It's not often you get the opportunity to go over and play soccer in a different country, especially the United States.
I transferred to UIW after my first year because I felt like UIW gave me a better opportunity after I graduated college.
I hope to see you at the games this year. Go Cardinals.
Welcome back, Graham Doty here at Foster Field. Championship game we have been in the making here. Scoreless. Bottom of the fifth. Angelo State at the plate. Lee Newman. That's the whole crowd clapping for him in this plate appearance right here. 0 for 1 with a strikeout. First pitch from Perez. Downstairs, ball one. From Perez, slides away from ball two. Perez kicks and deals the 2-0. His slice foul. 2-1. Pete Perez has been on fire for the Texans. Six in a row retired. Two runners have been on base so far for the Rams. One hit by a pitch, one reached on an error. 2-2 to Newman. Here's the 2-2. Lifted in the air towards center field. Andrew Wolf hustles back, has the room, makes the catch. Newman is retired.
Ryan Greer.
Brings up Ryan Greer, who's 0-1. Greer was the player of the week on April 30th. He smacked 3 home runs with 12 RBIs versus Abilene Christian. Breaking ball, drops in for strike one. Career first team all conference selection, 12th highest batting average in the Lone Star Conference. Leads the conference in stolen bases. One pitch, he bunts one. It's hard right side. This could be trouble. Small can't get there. Let's see if that's a hit. Should be close. It is. Ruled a hit. Would have been a tough play for Ryan Small anyway. Tried to barehand it. But Greer's so fast. He's a good with an infield single. That is the first hit tonight for the Rams. Brings up Doug Snover. Single snaps. Pete Perez have retired 7 in a row. Throw over. And Greer gets back to the bag safely. Snover reached on an error back in the second. Was later caught stealing second base. Another throw over. Greer gets back to the bag safely. 29 stolen bases. Best in the conference. The Rams second most stolen bases in the Lone Star Conference as a team. Two guys with 20 stolen bases this year. One is Greer on first. The other one is Snover at the plate here.
Stover was the team captain in high school, led his team to the state championship. Feeling he will have to wait and wait and wait because Pete Perez is going to throw to first base a lot to keep an eye on Ryan Greer. He goes home this time. It's foul off for strike two. Over batting 298 with three home runs and 30 RBIs. Perez 0-2. It's 1-2. Two pitch on the way. It's rolled to the third baseman, Thompson. He goes to second for one. Smalls throw over, not in time, as Stover beats it out. There are two down and one on. Bounced out to the pitcher, Perez. Another throw over to first. Stover. So he has some dirt on his pants as he takes his lead. First, he goes to second again. The throw down to second base is not in time. Goes into shallow right field. Over goes to third. He gets there standing up. He gets waved home. The throw from Ryan Small to play at the plate is in time. And Stover is gunned down at home plate to win the bottom of the fifth inning. You gotta love Kevin Brooks being super aggressive over there at third base, sending Stover. We are still scoreless. You're watching the Lone Star Conference Baseball Tournament at FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
The LSC would like to thank the following corporate partners. Firestone, we keep your car running newer, longer. Three shops, one stop, maintenance, repairs, and tires. AccuConference, providing conference calling for the Lone Star Conference. Shut Sports, official softball helmet of the Lone Star Conference. Alpha Graphics, providing printing solutions for the Lone Star Conference. My Sports Streams, providing fundraising solutions for Lone Star Conference member institutions. Bravo Health, community engagement partner of the Lone Star Conference. Adidas, official supplier of the Lone Star Conference. Jostens, official ring provider of the Lone Star Conference. Wilson, the official basketball of the LSC. In the Lone Star Conference, we're committed to respect, integrity, tradition, community, and academic excellence. Lone Star Conference, we're the one. Fans, don't forget to like the Lone Star Conference on Facebook. It's the best way to stay connected to all the latest information from around the league and join the conversation with other LSC fans. For an easy way to follow the latest happenings in the Lone Star Conference, be sure to follow the LSC on Twitter. Get scoring updates, event reminders, and breaking news when you follow the Lone Star Conference on Twitter.
Still scoreless. We make our way to the top of the sixth inning. Grand 30 here at Foster Field for the Lone Star Conference Baseball Championship. There you see Rick Reyna has only allowed two hits so far. Both hits singles. The last one came in the third inning. 8-9-1 at the plate for the Texans. Ty Crump, first pitch swinging, hits it a mile in the air on the infield. Cohen and Stover, and Stover makes the catch. One pitch and one out.
Shortstop Evan Robinson.
Brings up the shortstop, Evan Robinson. He walked in the third. He was later thrown out at home plate by the center fielder, Lee Newman. Takes strike on there. One showing bunt in the dirt. It's even 1-1. Robinson, his specialty is sacrifice bunts. He's in the top 30 in the nation in that category. Drops one foul, third base side there. One ball, two strikes. Robinson one for two with a walk earlier today against the Abilene Christian Wildcats. This is the championship. Tarleton has to beat Angelo State twice to win it. The Texans win tonight. We will play again tomorrow. The player is looking for a base hit in the right field. A one-out single for Evan Robinson. The base hit for the Texans in the top of the order coming up here for Tarleton State. Ryan Smalls, one for two with a single and a strikeout. Throw over. Robinson lunges back to the bag safely. Six for 14 this year in stolen bases. It's been a while since a Texans player's been at the plate with a runner on base. The last time it happened was in the third. That ball is bounced to third. Off the glove, a similar goes into shallow left field, and everybody will be safe. That is a base hit for Ryan Small. Back-to-back singles. Tarleton State moves Robinson to second. Small aboard on first, and the center fielder, Andrew Wolf, one out to work with on the top of the six. Wolf one for two, single, ground out. And a meeting on the mound on the way here for the Rams. Rick Moreno has been so good today. And really his first jam in this ball game with one out and two runners on Tarleton State. Coach Brooks talking things over not only with Rick Moreno, the entire infield. That brings up Andrew Wolf. After that meeting on the mound, 323 batting average, 33 RBIs, no home runs. First runner in scoring position, rather second runner in scoring position for the Texans. Swing and a miss for striking out. Last time this happened was the third. Ryan Small single. Evan Robinson was on second. Tried to go to home on the play. Lee Newman, the center fielder, threw him out at the plate to win the third. 0-1 pitch. Up curveball floats away. It's 1-1.
Say two.
Tarleton State has grounded into 12 double plays this year. And you see the middle infield for the Rams. Close to the bag at second. They would love the opportunity to turn one right here. Rainer steps off the mound. Wolf does not show bunt. Everybody stays put. One on the way. It is slapped foul. Strike two. Wolf, a senior from Dripping Springs, Texas. Played in 35 games a year ago with four starts when he batted 182 with two RBIs. 1-2 pitch, gets him a swing and miss. Both strikes out, the third one tonight for Rick Reyna. Two down and two on for Blake Segura. Big strikeout there for Rick Reyna as he tries to work out of this jam. A dangerous batter here. Blake Segura leads the Lone Star Conference in home runs. Robinson aboard on second, he singled. Small on first, he singled. Infield, outfield, deep. Segura 0 for 2, ground out, fly out tonight. Lifts the first pitch foul out of play down the right field line for strike one. Segura against Abilene Christian today 0 for 4. One from Reyna. It's bounced to the shortstop, Cohen. He goes to second. Close play, but the inning is over. Bang, bang play. Ryan Small kind of held his breath and thought he might have beat it, but we are still scoreless as we go to the bottom of the sixth. What a championship game so far. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
Angelo State University, affordable, better, closer. With one of the lowest tuition and fee schedules in Texas, Angelo State is affordable for all. Recognized by the Princeton Review as one of the top four public universities in the state, ASU is better than you imagine. And Angelo State's central location in Texas makes it closer than you think. Enjoy the freedom to explore your interests, cultivate your talents, and shape your future at Angelo State University. From here, it's possible.
What makes WT Athletics unique?
I do.
I do.
I do.
I do.
And so do you.
Yes, we have great facilities and championship programs, but it's the people that set us apart.
It's me and it's you.
Without our athletes and without our donors, we are just an organization. An organization without a cause.
Without a voice.
And without a purpose. Thank you for supporting the Buffalo Club.
For more information, please visit GoBuffsGo.com. Go Buffs!
Pete Perez back on the mound. He threw the first game of this tournament for the Texans in a 4-2 victory over Texas A&M Kings.
For the catcher, Andrew Lacombe.
Pete Perez on Saturday had 7 strikeouts against Texas A&M Kingsfield. Only 2 walks, 2 runs allowed, and the complete game victory for the Texans. And he's been just as effective tonight. First pitch, strike one against Andrew Lacombe. But only 1 hit allowed by Pete Perez. A single last inning. There's a bouncer foul. 0-2 to Lacombe. Kingsville only had 5 hits against Perez on Saturday. Kingsville was the 2 seed. They went 2 and out here in this tournament. It's their first 2 games. To Tarleton State and Abilene Christian. 1 ball, 2 strikes. To Lacombe, 0-for-1 with a ground out. Perez fires the 1-2 pitch, jams it as he rolls into it. Small bobbles it, but throw over in time. Nice stretch by Hardy. Andrew Lacombe, it was an adventure, but he is retired. Here's Tate Allison, the right fielder. Second plate appearance, 0-for-1 with a strikeout. Take strike one there. Last time Allison was up, mentioned his family moved to Egypt when he was 11. They did that because his dad worked as an oil and gas field manager. Hits that one in the air pretty deep towards right field. Crump still going back. Now squares up and makes the catch. That ball hit against the wind for Allison. He gave it a ride, but Ty Culp chased it down. Two away, top of the order here for Angelo State. Zach Cohen, third plate appearance, 0 for 1. Line out in the third. Inside ball one. The 1-0 from Perez. Foul off. Counts even. 1-1. Cohen is a senior from Houston, Texas. Attended Houston Westside High School. Here's the 1-1. Shot foul, first base side, strike two. Angelo State 25-9 all time against Tarleton State. 3-0 all time against the Texans in the tournament. Here's the 1-2, upstairs, 2-2. But this marks the sixth time this year these two teams have played each other. 2-2 pitch, right underneath the glove of the pitcher, Perez. There's the second base hit tonight for the Rams. A close play though at first, as Cohen took a hard turn. Had to dive back in, just barely beat the throw. And his award with a two-out single. Brings up Quade McKinnon. 2 years at Paradise Valley Community College. Batted over 300 there. With two home runs and 25 RBIs in Community College. Having a fantastic year for the Rams this year, batting 356 with three homers and 46 RBIs. Strike one. McKinnon has been a monster in this tournament, though, for the Rams at the plate. He scored 3 runs against the Texans with a double that drove in 2 runs. Takes that one low. It's 2-0. And Jonathan Schmitz.
All right, here we go. Talk to you.
Pete Perez.
Thank you all for your
support. Thank you all for your support. Thank you all for your support. McKinnon against West Texas A&M. Had 4 hits and 7 plate appearances. And he had 5 RBIs and 2 runs. He's been phenomenal in this tournament for Angelo State. 1-1 pitch, runs inside. And it is 2-1. McKinnon searching for his first hit tonight, though, against Perez. A little bit outside, it's 3-1. His first batter here in the top of the 6th, 2 outs, 2 on. And now a meeting on the mound here. Coach Brian Conner comes over with Perez very quickly, along with the entire infield. Going on 2nd. He smacked a 2 out single. McKinnon is on 1st now after drawing that walk. Toby Simler, the batter, he's 0 for 2 with 2 flyouts. Perez in a jam here. He had a no-hitter through four tonight. His first pitch hit in the air. Ty Crump branching over to his left. And that will finish off the bottom of the sixth. Angelo State really for the first time knocking on the door. Leaves two runners stranded on the bases. We're scoreless as we head to the top of the seventh. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. Here in the championship game, Graham Doty here at Foster Field. We have made it to the top of the seventh. After 2 days, weather was a major factor in this tournament, especially yesterday between these two teams. First pitch. Yesterday, these two teams started off at noon. We had two separate weather delays that lasted a total of 8 hours. And we wrapped things up around 10:30. 1-1 pitch was lifted out of play. Strike two. One ball, two strikes to Garrett Hardy. 0-for-2 with two ground outs tonight. Keep you updated on the NBA playoffs. There's four games going on tonight. All four games, somebody could get eliminated as well. In Indianapolis, Pacers 50, Magic 47. Pacers beat that series 3-1. In Atlanta, Celtics in front 15-9 over the Hawks. There's a slow roll on the right side. First baseman McKinnon from the knees throws it over. Reyna covers and he's out. Nice play by McKinnon from his knees. He was able to get Garrett Hardy. Nice job by Reyna to cover first base. You see him chuckling. One down. Brings up Jonathan Schmitz. But Boston and Atlanta, Celtics lead the series 3-1. They're winning right now 15-9. Games later tonight in Chicago, the 76ers take on the Bulls. 76ers lead that series 3-1. Really, Chicago not the same since Derrick Rose tore his ACL. Last game tonight is the Lakers at home against the Nuggets. LA trying to close out the series against Denver. Two balls, no strikes to Jonathan Schmitz. Base is empty, one out here in the top of the seventh. Reyna's 2-0 offering. Heads in there, 2-1. Baseball wise in major leagues, Yankees and Rays in New York. Yankees in front 2-0 in the top of the fifth there. As that 2-1 pitch is fouled off, it's 2-2. James Shields looks to become the American League's first six-game winner for the Rays. Giants and Dodgers later tonight. Clayton Kershaw on the mound for the Dodgers. The 2-2 pitch out off stays 2-2. So James Shields going for win number six. How about in the National League, Lance Lynn, a former Ole Miss Rebel, is the first pitcher to get six wins in the National League. 2-2 pitch, blow it away, it's a full count. This is the second full count for Reyna today. He's only walked one way back in the third. Here's the payoff pitch, hit in the air pretty deep towards center field. Newman squares up, makes the catch, two down. Brings up Landon Thompson, 0-2, ground out, strikeout. There's a hard hit ball, one hopper to Cohen at short. He whips it over, and 1-2-3 inning for Rick Reyna on the top of the seventh. And it's time to stretch here at Foster Field in the championship game. We are scoreless. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsNorthwest.com.
I chose Division II because athletes graduate at a higher rate.
I can stay closer to home and be an important part of the community. I chose Division II because I can double major
and take part in campus activities.
I chose Division II because classrooms are smaller.
Students have more time with their instructors.
And I can compete for a national championship. I chose Division II for all these reasons and more.
I chose
Division II.
What is Javelina Pride? It's learning by doing research. It's tailgating before the big game. It's being part of a world-respected engineering program. Texas A&M University Kingsville, the home of Javelina Pride. Find out more at tamuk.edu.
Bottom of the seventh, we are scoreless between Angelo State and Tarleton State for the championship. 5-6 Angelo State, a lot on the line for them. Hosting here at Foster Field for the first time ever is the number one seed. They win this thing, they could easily be the number one seed in the South Central Regional Tournament. They need help. They need Central Missouri and St. Mary's to not do so well in their tournaments, which will be starting on Thursday of this week. 0-1 to Brett Parsons. And on the other side for Tarleton State, they're 30-19 on the outside looking in, as far as being one of the top eight seeds in the region. But it helped them that West Texas A&M lost their first two games and was eliminated very quickly in this conference tournament here. 1-1 pitch from Perez. Parsons checks the swing, he went around. 1-2. So it's very possible that the Texans can make it to the tournament. Two pitch from Perez. Upstairs ball two. See action, or you just saw action in the Angelo State bullpen down the left field line. Here's the 2-2 pitch. A little bit off the plate, a full count. Third full count tonight for Pete Perez. Remember, Tarleton State has to beat Angelo State twice. Once tonight, once tomorrow. There's a swing and a miss and a strikeout for Pete Perez. One down here in the seventh. Strikeout number five for Perez tonight. But if the Texans do not go off the ramps tonight, we will continue the championship tomorrow at noon right here on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
There's a slow roll at first base side. Hardy will take it himself. A sliding attempt by Newman, but he is out.
Leftover Ryan Greer.
The base is empty. Two down for Ryan Greer. He's one for two with a single and a ground out. Look like Jake Albert warming up, the sophomore from Conroe, Texas, for the Rams. First pitch showing bunt, poking on foul is Greer for strike one. But Rick Reyna so far has pitched very well. He's pitched seven innings so far for Angelo State, three strikeouts, one walk. Only allowed four hits, all singles. But his arm might be starting to get tired as the 0-1 pitch from Perez is down off for strike two. Perez pitched a complete game victory not that long ago on Saturday for the Texans, trying to will his squad to a victory here in the championship today. Here's his 0-2 pitch. High and away. Ball one. Look how focused Pete Perez looks. 1-2 is bounce foul, third base side. It remains 1-2. Perez fires the 1-2. There's a hard shot right at the second base, but deep in the hole. Small throws a dart over, and a 1-2-3 inning for Pete Perez. He's retired. We are still scoreless as we move to the top of the eighth here in the championship game. This is the Lone Star Conference at FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
The LSC would like to thank the following corporate partners. Firestone, we keep your car running newer, longer. Three shops, one stop, maintenance, repairs, and tires. AccuConference, providing conference calling for the Lone Star Conference. Shut Sports, official softball helmet of the Lone Star Conference. Alpha Graphics, providing printing solutions for the Lone Star Conference. My Sports Streams, providing fundraising solutions for Lone Star Conference member institutions. Bravo Health, community engagement partner of the Lone Star Conference. Adidas, official supplier of the Lone Star Conference. Jostens, official ring provider of the Lone Star Conference. Wilson, the official basketball of the LSC. In the Lone Star Conference, we're committed to respect, integrity, tradition, community, and academic excellence. Lone Star Conference, we're the one. Fans, don't forget to like the Lone Star Conference on Facebook. It's the best way to stay connected to all the latest information from around the league and join the conversation with other LSC fans. For an easy way to follow the latest happenings in the Lone Star Conference, be sure to follow the LSC on Twitter. Get scoring updates, event reminders, and breaking news when you follow the Lone Star Conference on Twitter.
Austin Church, the new pitcher on the mound for Angelo State, scoreless in the top of the eighth. Church, the lefty, a junior from Missouri, coming into relief starter Rick Reyna. Reyna finishes very strong, seven innings, four hits allowed, no runs, three strikeouts, and only one walk for Rick Reyna. Now he turns it over to Austin Church. Church's numbers this year, 3 wins, 2 losses, a 3.13 ERA, making his 26th appearance tonight, 37 in the third innings. Pitched this year for Church, he's given up 29 hits, 14 runs, 13 of those runs earned, 41 strikeouts, and 26 walks for Church this season.
Church facing the bottom third, 7-8-9 for the Texans. This is Chris Patton, the left fielder, who's 0-2. This pitch from Church pops the net, strike one. Church made the honorable mention Lone Star team this year. The ZRA is 12th best in the Lone Star Conference. Hits the outside corner there. He's in front. Nothing and two to Patton. But Church is a transfer from the University of Central Missouri. Played basketball in high schools. Team won the state championship back in 2005. That one's fouled off. It stays 0-2. So it's kind of ironic, Church transfer from the University of Central Missouri. And right now, Central Missouri is standing in the way of Angelo State being the number one seed in the South Central region. The 2-2 pitch upstairs. Another 0-2 pitch. Now it's 1-2 to Pat. Rolling away. Now it's 2-2 to Chris Pat. Patton set out all of last year. Started 31 games this year, but he goes down on strikes right there. Austin Church strikes out the first batter he sees.
Right fielder, Ty Grubb.
Brings up Ty Grubb. Fly out to right in the third, pop out on the infield in the sixth. Shows bunt inside, all the way to the backstop for ball one. A total of 6 hits in this game. All of them singles. 4 for the Texans, 2 hits for the Rams. That ball is popped up in the air, out of play. Nothing and two. Crompa Jr. from McKinney, Texas, steps back in. Outside, 1-2. Crump is 1 of 4. Rather, 1 of 5 in his family. His cousin Matt Smith played for Texas Tech, drafted by the Oakland A's. He's worked it even to 2-2. Swung on and missed. Back-to-back strikeouts for Church as Lacombe walks on down to first to get Crump. So it's a strikeout with a 2-3 attachment put on the end of it.
Shortstop Evan Robinson.
2 down for Evan Robinson. Seven in a row retired by Rams pitchers. The last runners to get on in the sixth. Really the best chance for Tarleton State. They had 2 runners on. One out, but Andrew Wolf struck out. Blake Sabirio bounced out. 2 in the six. 1 ball, 1 strike here to Robinson, who's 1-for-1 with a single and a walk. The pitch runs inside for ball 2. Robinson was thrown out the plate, though. Thrown out at home plate. 2 in the bottom of the third. That ball's popped up out of play. It's 2-2. Robinson was on second base. Ryan Small hit a single to center field. Robinson was waved towards home. And the center fielder, Lee Newman, threw him out and home plate. A little outside, the count is four. First full count for Church. Trying to strike out the side. Can he do it? The ball's ricocheted up the middle. Shortstop Cohen, the throw over. In time. 1-2-3. Go down the Texans. And the top half of the eighth. Still scoreless. This is the Lone Star Conference Championship at FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
Launch yourself into the future of technology at East New Mexico University in Portales. When you experience the Eastern Way, you'll experience a state-of-the-art computer center, full access to the internet in classrooms and residence halls, college-credit instructional TV courses in different cities and high schools, even student-produced programs on Eastern's own public radio and TV stations. For registration information or how to get launched aboard one of Eastern's 60 undergraduate and graduate majors, call 1-800-4-ENMU.
Second baseman,
Dutch Snover. Good day to bring your family to the ballpark here at Austin Field. Our scoreless Pete Perez still on the mound here for the Texans, facing Dutch Snover. Second baseman. He's been on base twice, though. Strike one. Snover reached on an error in the second. Reached on the fielder's choice in the fifth. He's been caught stealing, and he has a stolen base as well. Spotted foul for strike two. Tarleton State has to beat Angelo State twice to win the championship, if need be. If the Texans win, we will play again tomorrow at noon right here on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. 1-2 to Doug Snover. The Rams have won 10 straight, trying to win their second Lone Star Conference tournament. It's popped up. It stays 1-2. Last time the Rams did that was back in 2007. State has won the tournament twice as well. 1-2 pitch. Slide over. Foul off. These two teams were a couple of the hottest teams coming in. Both won 9 straight games until they played each other yesterday. And Angelo State just trounced Tarleton State yesterday in that marathon game. Game yesterday, first pitch was 12. We ended at 10:30 p.m. Pete Perez, making Perez work, nothing else. Running up the pitch count here for Perez. We're in the bottom of the eighth. Perez just pitched on Saturday, a complete game victory. Running in the dirt there.
full count tonight for Pete Perez. Angelo State fans starting to make some noise. Here's the payoff pitch. It is slapped foul once again, and the battle continues. This will be pitch number 10. Pete Perez to Snover. Foul off once again. Three balls, two strikes, it stays. Snover, the leadoff man here in the bottom of the eighth in a scoreless game for the championship. Perez fires the payoff pitch. Slow roll to the left side. Third baseman Thompson throws it on the run. Not in time. Snover beats it out. What an at bat from Doug Snover. And he gets a huge reaction from the Rams. Fans here. Infield single. Just the third hit tonight for Angelo State. All singles. First hit. Outs and a sixth inning. Andrew Lacoa steps in. He's 0 for 2 with two ground outs. Immediately squares around and shows bunt. Oh, over. Snover back at the bag safely. Has to be 20 stolen bases this year for Angelo State, second on the team. Being held on by Harvey in your pitcher there. Go down to first and diving back in safely. Snover. One and oh to Andrew Lacombe. Leadoff runner aboard for the Rams. For only the second time tonight, first since the first inning. Runner goes, it's fouled off. One and one. Pete Perez had a no-hitter through four. Gave up the first hit of the ball game, a single in the fifth off the bat of Ryan Rear. Five strikeouts tonight for Pete Perez. 1-1 shows bunt. This is a good one. First base side. Perez, the pitcher, calls for it. Underhands it. One down. Andrew Lacombe, a fantastic bunt, advances over from the first to second. Runner in scoring position, one out. The number nine batter, Tate Allison, 0 for 2, strikeout, flyout. From Perez, curveball, Thompson, strike one. There is somebody starting to warm up in the Texans bullpen. Not in any rush though, down the right field line. Pete Perez pitched a complete game victory on Saturday. 0-1, right back up the middle. Robinson, the shortstop, throws it over, one down. Snover goes from second to third on the play. Rather, two down after that. Top of the order here, Zach Cohen has a chance to be the hero. He's been on base twice, one for two, with a single and a lineout. Cohen batting 229 with 22 RBIs, takes one in the dirt there, all one. Perez this year, only one wild pitch. One here, though, could possibly give the Rams the first run of the game. Cohen at the plate, missed the first month of the season with a foot injury. One out. Brooks says, I know it's unusual to put a guy batting 220 in the leadoff spot. Since Cohen was hurt and it's just now starting to get back to form. That's that 1-1 pitch on. Two strikes. Huge pitch coming up here from Pete Perez. Sports ball game. Bottom of the eighth. Championship on the line. Go ahead run just 90 feet away. Upstairs, 2-2. Upstairs again, full count to Zach Cohen. Second full count in this inning for Pete Perez as his pitch count continues to increase. 0-1 at third, left inning off with a single. Payoff pitch, lifted in the air, foul, out of play, first base side. Garrett Hardy watches it bounce to the grandstands here at Foster Field. Two pitch, foul off again, right side. And Zach Cohen is putting in a battle here, making Pete Perez work here. Bottom of the eighth, the scoreless ball game. Payoff pitch from Perez. Off again. Pitch number 9 on the way. Pete Perez. Slow roller left side. Thompson Glove bobbles it to third. And the Rams leave the runner stranded on third base. We're scoreless. We have played 8 complete innings. Texans at the plate when we come back. This is the Lone Star Conference on Fox Sports.
The LSC would like to thank the following corporate partners. Firestone, we keep your car running newer, longer. 3 shops, 1 stop, maintenance, repairs, and tires. AccuConference, providing conference calling for the Lone Star Conference. Shut Sports, official softball helmet of the Lone Star Conference. Alpha Graphics, providing printing solutions for the Lone Star Conference. My Sports Streams, providing fundraising solutions for Lone Star Conference member institutions. Bravo Health, community engagement partner of the Lone Star Conference. Adidas, official supplier of the Lone Star Conference. Jostens, official ring provider of the Lone Star Conference. Wilson, the official basketball of the LSC. In the Lone Star Conference, we're committed to respect, integrity, tradition, community, and academic excellence. Lone Star Conference, we're the one. Fans, don't forget to like the Lone Star Conference on Facebook. It's the best way to stay connected to all the latest information from around the league and join the conversation with other LSC fans. For an easy way to follow the latest happenings in the Lone Star Conference, be sure to follow the LSC on Twitter. Get scoring updates, event reminders, and breaking news when you follow the Lone Star Conference on Twitter.
Scoreless in the ninth for the Lone Star Conference Tournament Championship.
Leading off,
Angelo State and Tarleton State. Rams the number 1 seed, the Texans the 5 seed. The 6th time this year these two teams have played each other. Second in the tournament. Austin Church, first pitch strike. Giants on top of the order here. For the Texans, Small today, 2-for-3, a pair of singles and a strikeout. Bounce off the 0-1, out of play, strike 2. Tarleton
Tarleton State got here by knocking off Texas A&M Kingsville on Saturday when Pete Perez threw a complete game victory. It's the 0-2 pitch right away, one to the small. Tarleton State knocked off Incarnate Word on Sunday, 3-2, and a come from behind win. And Tarleton State beat Abilene Christian earlier today. 2-2 pitch to Ryan Small. Angelo State has just been crushing everyone as of late. 2-2 pitch. This is chopped to the third baseman somewhere. This will be close. A throw to third. In time. He gets Ryan Small. And a tough play by the third baseman, Toby Simler. Angelo State has won 10 in a row. They have scored at least 11 runs in four straight, and six of the last seven. And off the plate, 1-0 to Wolf. 1-for-3 with a single, ground out, strikeout. Angelo State beat Tarleton yesterday 16-0. From Church. Wolf chase right out of the zone. Two balls, one strike. But the Texans have never beaten the Rams in the tournament play. Pitch hits the outside edge. It's 2-2. The last time Angelo State didn't score at least 11 runs was the 28th in a 4-2 victory over Abilene Christian. 2-2, there's a blooper foul. First base side, stays 2-2. The longest losing streak this year for the Rams. They've lost two games in a row three times. Over to first and down. Close play though. There's two down here in the top of the ninth. Brings up the man who leads the Lone Star Conference in home runs, Blake Seguero. He's 0-for-3 with two ground outs and a flyout. Pops that one up for strike one. Seguero 0-for-4 in the game earlier today. One for four against Angelo State the other day. Hits that one in the air to center field. Lee Newman settles underneath it, makes the catch. And the Texans go down 1-2-3 in the top of the ninth. The Rams have their chance here with 2-3-4 coming up to the plate when we come back. We are scoreless for the championship game coming up to the bottom of the ninth. This is the Lone Star Conference.
After visiting Incarnate Word, I decided that the coaching staff, the professors, and the atmosphere were all a great fit for me.
Often you get the opportunity to go over and play soccer in a different country, especially the United States.
I transferred to UIW after my first year because I felt like UIW gave me a better opportunity after I graduated college.
I hope to see you at the games this year. Go Cardinals!
Angelo State University, affordable, better, closer. With one of the lowest tuition and fee schedules in Texas, Angelo State is affordable for all. Recognized by the Princeton Review as one of the top four public universities in the state, ASU is better than you imagine. And Angelo State's central location in Texas makes it closer than you think. Enjoy the freedom to explore your interests, cultivate your talents, and shape your future at Angelo State University. From here, it's possible.
Leading off the bottom of the ninth, the first baseman, Wade McKinnon.
bottom of the ninth in a scoreless ball game for the Lone Star Conference Tournament Championship. Wade McKinnon leads things off. Pete Perez still on the mound here for Tarleton State. First pitch to McKinnon, high and outside, ball one. Perez threw just 3 days ago a complete game victory over West Texas A&M. Behind 2-0 to Quade McKinnon, who's 0-2 with a walk tonight. T.O. is high and away from all three. You have to wonder what that right arm of Pete Perez feels like after throwing a complete game victory just 3 days ago. Right now, I think the plan for head coach Brian Conklin, if we want to have a chance, we got to win this one. Got to throw our best pitcher, Pete Perez, in this first game. A five-pitch walk. Only the second run allowed tonight for Pete Perez. And the leadoff runner is aboard for the second straight inning for the Rams. Brings up Toby Simler, who's 0-3. Three flyouts in the outfield. On the stretch, he shows bunt. That one drifts in there for strike one. Swings around again, puts that one straight up in the air and out of play. Simler catches a break. He's down in the count, nothing and two. 366 average for Simler. Three home runs, 39 RBIs. The 3-4 hitters tonight for the Rams combined 0-6. Three strikeouts. Another for Pete Perez. He gets Toby Simler to go down swinging on the first out. And that brings up Brett Parsons. He's 0-3 with three strikeouts tonight. One out, one on. Bottom of the ninth. We are scoreless. Championship on the line. Possibly number one seed in the South Central Tournament on the line for the Rams. Low ball out to Parsons. Parsons, 367 hitter, four home runs, 42 RBIs. Only walked 15 times this year. Lifts that one in the air towards center field. Andrew Wolf still going back, makes the catch on the run. Fires it back on the infield. That ball is hit hard for once. Pete Perez still hanging in there. For the Texans, two out, one on for the co-conference player of the year, Lee Newman. Newman 0-3. Strikeout, flyout, ground out. On the stretch, first pitch from Perez. Bounced to the shortstop. Robinson flips it. Small, and the inning is over. The leadoff walk does not come back to haunt Pete Perez. And we have extra innings in the Lone Star Conference Baseball Tournament Championship. We'll be right back. You're watching. All-Star Conference.
foxsportssouthwest.com.
The LSC would like to thank the following corporate partners. Firestone, we keep your car running newer, longer. Three shops, one stop, maintenance, repairs, and tires. AccuConference, providing conference calling for the Lone Star Conference. Shut Sports, official softball helmet of the Lone Star Conference. Alpha Graphics, providing printing solutions for the Lone Star Conference. My Sports Streams, providing fundraising solutions for Lone Star Conference member institutions. Bravo Health, community engagement partner of the Lone Star Conference. Adidas, official supplier of the Lone Star Conference. Jostens, official ring provider of the Lone Star Conference. Wilson, the official basketball of the LSC. In the Lone Star Conference, we're committed to respect, integrity, tradition, community, and academic excellence. Lone Star Conference, we're the one. Fans, don't forget to like the Lone Star Conference on Facebook. It's the best way to stay connected to all the latest information from around the league and join the conversation with other LSC fans. For an easy way to follow the latest happenings in the Lone Star Conference, be sure to follow the LSC on Twitter. Get scoring updates, event reminders, and breaking news when you follow the Lone Star Conference on Twitter.
All right, here we go. Extra innings. Graham Doty here at Foster Field. Scoreless ball game. Austin Church came in the eighth. Cheerleaf starter Rick Moreno. He's pitching well. His first pitch is a ball outside to Garrett Hardy. Church has faced six batters, retired everybody. First base hit for Hardy. A leadoff single. Brings up the catcher, Jonathan Schmitz, 0 for 3, 2 flyouts, and a ground out. Similar. Way in. Doug Snover, the second baseman, is prepared to go to first. The 1-0 is poked foul. Tarleton State, at least for now, plans are to manufacture a run here in the top of the 10th. Hardy aboard on first after his leadoff single. Schmidt squares around. Is it back? All two. Schmidt 2 for 3 against Abilene Christian in the second game today. 2-1. What's that one foul? It's even. 2-2. Six, seven, eight hitters coming up here for Tarleton State. A combined 0 for 9 with 3 strikeouts. Go over the first. Hardy gets back safely. Hardy does have speed, 19 stolen bases. Most for the Texans. 2-2 pitch. Low and away. Full count. Second full count for Austin Church. Let's see if Jonathan Schmitz still wants to bunt here with the full count. Running on first and nobody out. He does indeed square around. Here's the pitch. He bunts it. It's fair. Second baseman Stover, whether that's first baseman, gets the out. Doug Stover covering first base. Leaves Hardy to second on the play. New batter is Landon Thompson. 0 for 3, 2 ground outs, and a strikeout. Runner in scoring position. One out in the top. top of the 10th and score this ball game for the Lone Star Conference Tournament Championship. Check swing that's fouled off from Thompson for strike one.
Here we go. Get your side. LT, step out.
Hardy is the first base runner since the sixth inning for the Texans. He's in scoring position. Church from the stretch fires the 0-1. Floats in. Strike two. Thompson last game was 2 for 4, two singles, an RBI, and a run scored against the Wildcats of Abilene Christian. It's 0-for-3 tonight, though. That'll make it 0-for-4. He goes down looking. Austin Church with his third strikeout tonight. Left fielder Chris Patton gets his chance, 0-for-3 with a strikeout, two outs. A go-ahead run in scoring position, and Garrett Hardy led this inning off with a single. First pitch, a curveball, drops away for ball one. Infield and outfield playing Patton straight away here. 1-0 pitch, a little outside, it's 2-0. Rams have won 10 straight. Tarleton State had won 9 straight before losing yesterday to the Rams. 2-0 pitch hit in the air. This should do it. Tate Allison, the right fielder, makes the catch, and the top of the 10th is over. Tarleton State leaves Garrett Hardy stranded on second base. To the bottom of the ninth we go. We are scoreless. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
State University. Affordable, better, closer. With one of the lowest tuition and fee schedules in Texas, Angelo State is affordable for all. Recognized by the Princeton Review as one of the top 4 public universities in the state, ASU is better than you imagine. And Angelo State's central location in Texas makes it closer than you think. Enjoy the freedom to explore your interests, cultivate your talents, and shape your future at Angelo State University. From here, it's possible.
Welcome back. It's the bottom of the 10th. Graham Doty here at Foster Field. And Pete Perez pitched a magical 9 innings, but unfortunately he will not be able to pick up the victory. But Perez finishes 9 innings, only allowed 3 hits, all singles, 2 walks for Perez, and 6 strikeouts. There you see Britt Robertshaw, who's equally as nasty as Pete Perez on the mound. Robert Shaw, a junior from Cedar Park, Texas. In game two today, he pitched three innings and picked up the save over Abilene Christian, his eighth save this season, but you have to wonder how fresh he is. Ryan Greer leads the inning off here for Angelo State. Ryan Conger did say Britt Robertshaw has been a starter in his career, was supposed to be a number two starter, but they moved him to the closer role. So he is certainly going extended innings here tonight. Ryan Greer, 1-for-3. That one high and away. Bounce level, 1-1. Greer grounded out in the second, singled in the fifth, grounded out in the seventh. 1-1 pitch. Slaps that one out of play for strike two. Greer second on the team with a 367 average. Played in all 53 games this year, 6 home runs, 56 RBIs. The 1-2, fouled off. It remains 1-2.
Stay easy, just made it. Stay easy, right on.
One two from Robert Shaw. Fouled off the mask of the catcher, Schmitz. Stays 1-2. But against Abilene Christian, Robert Shaw, one strikeout, 2 walks, did not give up a hit in the 3 innings he pitched. 1-2 pitch, there's a blooper right at the third baseman, Thompson, 1 down. Brings up Doug Snover. He's been on base all 3 times tonight. First pitch swinging, bounces one, pass a diving, Robinson is short. A 1-out single for Doug Snover. His second base hit tonight. And the Rams have a runner on here in the bottom of the 10th. Brings up the catcher, Andrew Lacombe. 0-for-2, 2 ground outs. And a sacrifice bunt. Throw over to first. Snover gets back safely. 21 stolen bases this year. He has 1 tonight. Also was caught stealing in the second. Robert Shaw again throws over. And Snover is now almost covered completely in dirt. First pitch home. Strike 1 to Lacombe. Goes. Pitch misses outside. The throw down to second in time. Snover's caught stealing for the second time tonight. Jonathan Schmitz, a huge out there as he guns down Snover. Base is now erased. 1 ball, 1 strike to Andrew Lacombe. Each team has had a play at the plate in which a runner was thrown out. Doug Snover was thrown out at home back in the 4th. Evan Robinson thrown out for the Texans in the 3rd. 2-2. That ball is hit in the air. Foul off. Stays 2-2. 8-9 batters tonight so far for Angelo State. A combined 0-7. Allison on deck is 0-3. There's a 2-2 pitch. Oh, and missed. Robert Shaw fans Lacombe for the third and final out of the inning. And we continue to the top of the 11th. We are scoreless. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
We strive for academic excellence. We believe in engaging our community. We're proud of our tradition. We exemplify respect on and off the field. We conduct ourselves with integrity, and we're committed to being the best. That's why we're the one. Lone Star Conference, we're the one.
Lights are on at the ballpark here at Foster Field as the sun begins to go down. New pitcher on the mound for the Rams is Mike Weatherly, a right-handed pitcher, junior from Texas, 6'5", 195, coming in for Austin Church. Church goes three innings to relieve starter Rick Rainham. Church finishes with three strikeouts, no walks, one hit allowed. He retired everybody he faced but Garrett Hardy, who singled in the 10th. Austin Church, fantastic. As well as the starter, Rick Rain, a lot of great pitching tonight for both teams. But now it's up to Weatherly. Weatherly, 5 wins, 2 losses. Making his 24th appearance tonight, a 2.87 ERA, 31 and a third innings this year, 25 hits, 10 runs, all earned, 42 strikeouts, and only 15 walks this year for Weatherly, facing 8-9-1 batters for Tarleton State. Ty Crump, 0-3 with a strikeout, leads things off. Weatherly from the stretch with the bases empty. First pitch, high and tight to Crump. Weatherly, first team all conference selection this year. Pitcher of the week on February 19th. His 1-0 pitch runs inside and it hits Crump. And he's awarded first base. So the leadoff runner is aboard for the second straight inning for the Texans. Weatherly this year has 9 saves, which is 18th in the nation. He played 2 years at Eastfield Community College when he won the 2011 National Championship for the NJCAA. Evan Robinson at the plate. A very good bunter as he squares around. Pitch misses high for ball one. Top of the 11th. Lone Star Conference Tournament Championship on the line. If the Texans win tonight, we would play one more tomorrow at noon right here on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. 1-0 misses high, it's 2-0. Albinton in the top 30 in the nation and sacrifice bunts. Trying to do that right now. It's 2-0. There's a strike. One pitch just off the plate. It's 3-1. Rams pitchers have only walked one batter tonight. 3-1 pitch. Punt right back to the pitcher. Rolls foul though on the first base side. That ball had all kinds of spin on it. Landed in the grass, then immediately went towards the right. Three balls, two strikes to Robinson. The only walk of this ball game for Angelo State pitchers came back in the third. A walk to the man at the plate, Evan Robinson. Squares around with the full count. And he takes ball four. Mike Weatherly homing into action for the first time tonight. Puts two runners on. Trump moves to second. Robinson now on first. Still nobody out in the top of the order here for the Texans. Small, 2-for-4 with a pair of singles, has been a clutch in this tournament for the Texans. Weatherly steps off the mound. Small, not bunting. I wouldn't expect him to bunt right here just because he's been hitting the ball so well. Game two today against Abilene Christian. He hit the go-ahead sack fly in the seventh to score on Landon Thompson. Tarleton State went on to win 3-2 thanks to that sack fly. And against Incarnate Word, Ryan Small, a bases clearing double for a 3-2 victory for Tarleton State as well over Incarnate Word. That one's high and tight. 1-0 to Small. Good speed on the bases for Tarleton State. Crump on second, Robinson aboard on first. The 1-0 home is bounced to the left side of the infield. Crump gets the wave around third. He hits for home. Play at the plate, not in time. And the first run of the ball game, an RBI single from Ryan Small. Clutch again. 1-0. Texans leading the Rams. Just squeeze one through the left side of that infield. Ryan Small has ice water in his veins. Still nobody out. Robinson on second. Small aboard on first. Andrew Wolf at the plate. 1-for-4. Singled way back in the first. Takes a strike outside there. Mike Weatherly just allowed his 11th run this season.
Come on, Bay! This one right here, kid!
His 0-1 pitch downstairs, 1-1.
Two.
runners go. Popped up. Foul territory. First base sign out of the reach of McKinnon. One ball, two strikes. Brian Conger with a double steal here. At the top of the 11th. I guess you can do that now with the lead. And with Robert Shaw, your closer, on the mound for you, you can take those chances. One-two pitch from Weatherly. Strike three call. He gets Andrew Wolf looking for the first out. Seven total strikeouts tonight for the Angelo State pitching staff. One out, two on for Blake Seguero. His 11 home runs tops in the Lone Star Conference. Takes one outside for all one. Thompson tonight, though, 0 for 4. Bounce into a double play in the first. Grounded out. Two flyouts. The 1-0 from Weatherly. Lying away, it's 2-0. And Blake Seguero should get a pretty fat pitch on the way here from Mike Weatherly. What a game this has been in the championship between Tarleton State and Angelo State. 2-0 pitch, there's a line drive, base hit in the right field. Robinson rounds third, he heads for home. The throw from Allison, the plate is in time. Allison guns down Robinson for the second out. Small goes to third on the play. Seguero is at second. That was a hose thrown by Tate Allison and Wright. Two outs, two on for Garrett Hardy. One for four, he singled in his last at bat. First pitch from Weatherly in the dirt. Number one seed versus the number five seed. Rams in danger of having their 10-game win streak snapped. The 1-0, moving away from all two. If the Texans hold on, we will play tomorrow at noon right here on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. Rams are 3-0 all time against Tarleton State in the tournament. Here's the 2-0. Drops it for strike one. But when you play somebody six times in a year, you certainly become very familiar with each other. These two teams split the series at Tarleton State back in April. That ball's bounced to the left side of the infield. Small scores, rounding third is Seguero, and he stays put there. An RBI single from Garrett Hardy. It's 2-0. Texans in front. Seguero aboard on third. Hardy on first. And a pitching change here. We'll take a quick timeout. It's 2-0. Texans now lead the Rams. We'll be right back. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
I chose Division II because athletes graduate at a higher rate.
I can stay closer to home and be an important part of the community. I chose Division II because I can double major
and take part in campus activities.
I chose Division II because classrooms are smaller.
Students have more time with their instructors.
And I can compete for a national championship. I chose Division II for all these reasons and more.
I chose
Division II.
Learning by doing research. It's tailgating before the big game. It's being part of a world-respected engineering program. Texas A&M University, Kingsville, the home of Javelina Pride. Find out more at tamuk.edu.
2-0. Texans with two runs here in the top of the 11th. Jake Albert, the new pitcher on the mound. Two outs. Runners on the corners here for Tarleton State. First pitch strike to Jonathan Schmitz. Albert is a sophomore from Conroe, Texas. Conroe High School. His 0-1 pitch is in there for strike two. Final line on Mike Weatherly. Two-thirds of an inning. Three hits, two runs, both earned, no walks, and one strikeout. We were scoreless through the first 10. Tarleton State with two here in the top of the ninth. 0-2 pitch, out off, out of play, stays 0-2. Albert this year, one win, two losses, making his 23rd appearance. 3.90 ERA, 30 innings pitched this year, 25 hits, 15 runs, 13 of those runs earned, 19 strikeouts, 8 walks. Strike three called, and the inning is finally over, but the damage is done. Two runs in the top of the 11th for the Texans, and now the Rams are down to their final three outs here. We'll be right back. This is the Lone Star Conference on FoxSportsSouthwest.com.
Angelo State University, affordable, better, closer. With one of the lowest tuition and fee schedules in Texas, Angelo State is affordable for all. Recognized by the Princeton Review as one of the top four public universities in the state, ASU is better than you imagine. And Angelo State's central location in Texas makes it closer than you think. Enjoy the freedom to explore your interests, cultivate your talents, and shape your future at Angelo State University. From here, it's possible.
What makes WT Athletics unique?
I do.
I do.
I do.
I do.
And so do you.
Yes, we have great facilities and championship programs, but it's the people that set us apart.
It's me and it's you.
Without our athletes and without our donors, we are just an organization. An organization without a cause.
Without a voice.
And without a purpose. Thank you for supporting the Buffalo Club.
For more information, please visit GoBuffsGo.com. Go Buffs!
Two to nothing. Tarleton State. Britt Robertson.
Allison.
Trying to register the final three outs here in the bottom of the 11th. Robertson had a three-inning save against Abilene Christian. Game two today to eliminate the Wildcats. Now we can pick up the win in this game. B. Perez went nine innings. pitch from Robertshaw to Tate Allison. Ball one. 9-1-2, at least in this inning for Angelo State. Robertshaw's 1-0 pitch pops the net for even 1-1. You have to give Tarleton State credit. It's been an interesting few days here at Foster Field. A slow roller right side. Covering first is the pitcher, Robertshaw. He's there, one down. Top of the order, Zach Cohen coming up. Tarleton State won on Saturday. Played very late on Sunday. Finished their game against Incarnate Word around 1:15 in the morning. Yesterday, against Angelo State, Tarleton State lost 16-0 in a game that started at noon and ended around 10:30 at night. Two separate weather delays lasted 8 hours. Tarleton State comes out here today and beats Abilene Christian and have a two-run lead here with two outs to go against Angelo State to force another game in this championship, which will be tomorrow at noon right here on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. 3-1 the count, or 2-1 the count to Cohen. 1-for-3 tonight for Zach Cohen with a single. Battles that one off. 2-2. Tarleton State trying to hold on here. Angelo State this year, 35 home runs. Lee Newman has the most with 7. Newman in the 5 spot. Here's the payoff pitch to Kelly. Swing on and miss, strike 3. Robertshaw with a second strikeout. Fans Cohen. And now the Rams are down to their final out. First pitch to Quade McKinnon. High and away, ball one. McKinnon has been aboard twice. 2 walks, a strikeout, and a ground out. The 1-0 from Robertshaw. High and away. Ball two. The Rams just need to get one run on base. One runner on base, I should say. Because then the tying run will come up to the plate. That way you have a chance here. 2-1 now in the count to McKinnon. 3-4 hitters tonight, though, for the Rams. A combined 0-for-8 with 4 strikeouts. Two-one pitch, way upstairs. 3-1 to McKinnon. Toby Simler awaits on deck. 3 flyouts and a strikeout. 3-1 from Robertshaw. Right down the middle of the plate, full count. Rams down to their final strike. Now 2 runs here in the bottom of the 11th. Payoff pitch, jams him. This might be playable left side. Thompson is there. And Tarleton State wins 2-0 to force a game tomorrow at noon for the championship. What a pitching performance tonight for Pete Perez. Goes 9 innings and carries his team once again to a victory all the way to the championship game.